was an early morning barroom, and the place just opened up, and the little man came in so fast as he started at his cup. And the broad who serves the whiskey, she was a big old friendly girl who tried to fight her empty nights by smiling at the world. And she said, "Hey, Bob, it's been a while since you've been around. Where the hell you been hiding? And why you look so down?" Well, the little man just sat there like he'd never heard a sound. The waitress, she put out with a cough, and acting not the least put off, she spoke once again. She said, "I don't want to bother you. Consider it understood. I know I'm not no beauty queen, but I sure can listen good." And the little man took his drink in his hands, and he raised it to his lips, and he took a couple of sips, and then he told the waitress this story. "I am the midnight watchman down at Miller's Tool and I, and I watch the meadow rustling, I watch the time go by. A week ago at the diner, I stopped to get a bite, and this here lovely lady, she said, 2 cents for my ride." And Lord, 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 she was all right. That she could warm a winter's frost, but she looked long past lonely and well down to lost. Now I'm not much of a mover or a pick-em-up easy guy, but I decided to glide on over and give her one good try. And Lord, 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 she was worth a try. Well, I was tongue-tied like a schoolboy as I stammered out some words. Cause I don't think she heard. She just looked clear on through me to a space back in my head, and it shamed me into silence as quietly she said, "If you want me to come with you, that's all right with me, cause I know I'm going nowhere, and anywhere's a better place to be. Anywhere's a better place to be." Well, I drove her to my boarding house, and I took her up to my room, and I went to turn on the only light, brighten up the
blue. But she said, please leave the light off. Oh, I don't mind the dark. And as her clothes all tumbled round her, I could hear my heart. Well, the moonlight shone upon her as she lay back in my bed. It was the kind of scene I only had imagined in my head. I just could not believe it, to think that she was real. And as I tried to tell her, she said, shh, I know just how you feel. If you want me, come here with me, and that's all right with me, 'cause I've been oh so lonely. Loving someone is a better way to be. Well, the morning came so swiftly, I held her in my arms. When she slept like a baby, snug and safe from home, I did not want to share her or dare to break the mood. So before she woke, I went out to buy us both some food. Came back with had left a 6-word letter saying it's time that I moved on. No, the waitress, she took her bar rag and she wiped it across her eyes. And as she spoke, her voice rang out as something as a sigh. Said, I wished that I was beautiful, or that you were halfway blind. And I wished I wasn't so goddamn fat, and I wished that you were mine. And I wish that you'd come with me when I leave for home, 'cause we both know all about emptiness and living alone. And the little man looked at the empty glass in his hand, crooked grin. He said, I guess I'm out of gin, and I know we both